The Telecommunications Systems Department is responsible for planning, designing, constructing, and operating SRP's telecommunications network for the benefit of SRP customers. You can think of telecommunications systems as a telecom service provider for SRP. We're very much like a Cox or a CenturyLink for your residential home, and that we provide communication services to and from various SRP facilities. What makes us unique is our fiber optic network. Most other utilities don't have that robust of a fiber optic network.
So back in the late 1980s, SRP decided to invest in the future and start rolling out fiber throughout its entire system. As a result, over the next 30 years, we wound up installing close to 75,000 strand miles of fiber. And to give that some perspective, that's enough fiber to go around the world three times. It was unusual at that time, and SRP, as a result, is now far ahead of the curve in terms of our telecom capabilities.
Telecom C&M constructs and maintains all the electronics telecommunications systems between substations, office buildings, generation plants, and facilities. We are putting communication systems into buildings and racks. We're climbing towers, setting up antennas, dishes for communications. SRP owns 21 microwave mountaintop sites. We also have about 42 different microwave radio systems at the mountaintop sites. The radio system is used for communications by the field crews, the linemen, electricians, technicians. If there's ever any issues with communications out in the field, we're not relying on a third party to maintain the system. It's fully maintained by SRP employees.
What many people don't realize is that SRP telecommunications networks are actually the third grid. So we have the water grid, the power grid, and the telecommunications grid. The forethought from previous employees have brought the fiber connectivity to the transmission and generation grids. So now the FAN, the field area network, is about enabling that connectivity from the distribution substation into the distribution network and ultimately the customer. And from there, SRP now has a really good inlet into the control, monitoring, and operation of the electric and water power grids. The purchase of spectrum is a significant investment. Spectrum is a limited resource. It's private. It's owned and operated by the company. SRP could resell the spectrum. It's going to enable the future grid modernization efforts and sustainability efforts that SRP is currently embarking on.
SRP dark fiber sounds mysterious. Essentially, it's the unused portion of fiber cable. SRP licenses dark fiber to commercial customers, which is a value to the community and SRP customers. The benefit to SRP is that we help mitigate new construction by utilizing existing infrastructure, and we also focus on making incremental revenue to help offset SRP expenses. Innovation is not only solving the problem today, but anticipating future needs that might have additional shared benefit for everybody involved.